The sign on the door reads, "Celebrating 20 years of great cakes." And during that time, Lakewood, Colorado's Masterpiece Cake Shop has created art in the form of baked goods to keep customers coming back.
And what do you want it to say?
From cookies and cupcakes to signature cakes. Check out the mountain landscape on this one. Jack Phillips and his daughter Lisa have transformed their bakery into a studio. All of it, Jack says, inspired and motivated by his faith in Jesus Christ.
The most important thing that I think about throughout the day when I wake up, when I go to work, I want to know that what I'm doing is pleasing to Him, that I honor Him and His Word, because that's the most important thing.
Jack's Christian faith landed him in trouble with the law. His crime? Adhering to his biblical belief that marriage is between one man and one woman. In 2012, a homosexual couple sued Jack after he declined to make a cake to celebrate their marriage. An administrative law judge ruled against him, and the Colorado Civil Rights Commission agreed. The commission stated Jack's refusal went against the state's public accommodation law. It requires businesses to serve customers regardless of their sexual orientation. In a public statement, one member of the Civil Rights Commission said, "I can believe anything I want, but if I'm going to do business here, I'd ought to not discriminate against people."
I didn't discriminate against anybody. Like Nicole said, I've chosen not to make cakes for same-sex weddings. I told David and Charlie when they came in that I would sell them cookies and brownies and birthday cakes and shower cakes. I just don't do the same-sex wedding cake. So I did not discriminate against them, just that event that I've chosen not to participate in.
Jack's attorney, Nicole Martin, says the commission violated Jack's First Amendment rights, and she's taken the case to the Colorado Court of Appeals. The Civil Rights Commission's order requires Jack and his staff to make cakes for same-sex celebrations if asked. He must also re-educate his staff about Colorado's Anti-Discrimination Act. Under that law, artists must endorse all views. The order also requires him to put in place new policies to comply with the commission's order. In addition, he will submit quarterly compliance reports to the government for 2 years. According to Alliance Defending Freedom, the reports must include the number of customers declined a wedding cake or any other product and include why, so to ensure he has fully eliminated his religious beliefs from his business.
The government has chosen which message it favors in this case. I think the state has made it very clear. Jack's First Amendment rights, Jack's freedom to express himself, or more importantly, not express himself, must bow to the complainant's message. And all I can say is what that looks like to me is something very frightening. And that's nothing more than diversity through conformity. And that's not diversity at all.
Jack Phillips' case is one of a handful in which complainants sued private businesses for refusing to accommodate gay couples getting married. It also helped lead to controversial proposals in several states, allowing businesses to decline service based on the religious beliefs of owners.
This case is not about, and it never has been about, the young men that came in here almost 2 years ago asking Jack to design and create their cake. This case has always been about the message that that cake expresses, what that cake communicates.
It's surprising. This is not what they taught us in civics class. They could do this to you. They do this in other countries, not here.
So Jack stands on the First Amendment. In this case, we're going to learn whether the First Amendment has a future in America.
And in a country founded on freedom of religion and speech, that's a future important to all Americans. Mark Martin, CBN News, Lakewood, Colorado.